So we hear about a two-state solution, and sometimes we hear about a one-state solution, but there seems to be growing popularity in new types, new alternative solutions that we hear less about, but they are gaining in population. And you have one of those solutions that you've been working on for quite some time. From what I've heard, it seems unique, it seems sophisticated, and quite creative, and I've always said for such a complex conflict, we need a creative solution. So what is it exactly you're working on, Yoel?
Okay, so I've, like you said, I've been working on this for quite some time. Just a little bit about my background. So I was just saying to you privately that I'm originally from New York. You said you're from New Jersey. So growing up in the United States, it was very common or familiar. Everybody knows that, okay, there are 50 states and each state has its own governor and it has its own court system and its own state elections, but there is a federal government as well. And the motto of the country is e pluribus unum, out of many one. So you have this notion of, you have the two different flags different flags for different states. So federalism was a model that growing up in America was completely normal and natural. I've always, as a religious person, I've always had interest in communicating with other religious people, and it seemed that every time that I would meet with someone who was Muslim, that the magic word was Ibrahim. And as soon as you sort of said, okay, we're both either actual children of Abraham, or we are philosophical children of Abraham, all of a sudden it created a dialogue, an ability to talk with each other, that we're not the same, but we have something in common. And so it just it all sort of came together that I developed this paradigm called Abrahamic federalism, that really, in order to approach the situation, you need to address two issues. One is political symbolism, symbolism, and the other is political structure. So the structure is, I think, a model like New York, New Jersey, and Washington, D.C. as a possible model for Jerusalem, an area that is belonging to both or to all, as something that we can work with. Also, I've studied other federal models like the European Union, which is more of a confederation. We can talk a little bit about the differences between a federation and a confederation. We looked at Switzerland, Canada, Australia. There are other models where you can have two different flags, two different governments, but some other body that coordinates between these two bodies. And so I feel that this model of Abrahamic federalism shifts how we think about the situation. And Abraham as a unifying symbol, specifically for the Holy Land, seems to speak very clearly as to why the Jews are in the Holy Land in the first place. It's a very simple marker, but it's an ecumenical symbol that brings us together. And Abraham specifically, he represents, in both Judaism and Islam, is the element of hospitality, of kindness, of an open tent, welcoming to everyone. And that's, I think, what we're trying to replicate here. That everyone belongs here, everyone is welcome here. So people will sometimes ask, well, what about Buddhists and Hindus? I'm like, well, they're welcome too.
Everybody's welcome.
Everybody's welcome.
Yeah. And,